Hi, this is Sneha May Francis, and today on FC Early Bus, the spotlight is on Tiger Zinda Hai. Where director Ali Abbas Zafar resurrects an Indian spy to undertake a near-impossible mission to rescue nurses from the clutches of a terrorist organization. Set in Iraq, this one is loosely, and I mean very loosely, based on real-life incidents. But in here, the director decides to sell us a twisted tale of patriotism, uniting two warring countries on the battlefield against a common enemy. So here's a look at what I didn't like about the film. It's heavily inspired. It almost feels like a collage of TV series and action thrillers that we've already seen before. It's like a lot of movies packed into one. Possibly a way to be a sure shot money spinner. Like there's that last second bomb diffusion, or Salman Khan stepping out peppering bullets almost like an ode to Rambo. And there are those long preachy conversations. Now this is a film that's heavily invested in bombs and guns, and you would expect the weapons to do the work, right? But in here, suddenly the men decide to sell their ideologies to each other, which I thought was ridiculous, incoherent and illogical. Now given the genre, a lot of it can be overlooked, but in here Tiger is thrown into different sticky situations and he escapes them all without any trouble. He's always unharmed, barring for some beautifully designed bloody patches on his face. Some of it really make us chuckle, not in a good way. And there's Katrina Kaif, who's gorgeous, but in here she wears a piercing, sultry look at any given time, deflating her worth. And Salman Khan, who's got swag, which will definitely cheer up his fans, but for lovers of good cinema, it won't. These two are locked in an unnecessary love story. The first scene where you're introduced to Tiger fighting a pack of wolves is honestly very tacky. And the leader of a terrorist organization who ends up talking to his own men in English. You'd expect him to talk in their language, right? But possibly he knew he's going to have an audience around the world. And here's a look at what I liked about the film, the action sequences. Now, there are a lot of exceptional action set pieces. Looks like Ali Abbas Zafar designed the action and then decided to build a story around it. The particular one that involves a truck that spins over Salman. Nothing novel, but very well shot. And Paresh Rawal. Give him any character and he brings it to life on screen. It's seasoned actors like him who put the rest of the cast to shame. There are some new faces, very promising in their first attempt, but not allowed to do much to let the spy couple shine through, I think. Barring one, Sajjad Dellafrose, who makes a great first impression, even looks the part, but is unable to inject menace into Abu Usman. This is a flaw of the writers and not his. To sum it up, Tiger Zinda Hai bangs heavily and unapologetically on Salman Khan. So if you possess some undying love for the star, then this one's worth your popcorn. But for the rest of us, there are enough action series on the telly and on the tube to keep us going. And if you like this review, comment, share and subscribe to Film Companion.